Hello everyone, my name is Shambhavi and today we are going to see the three functions that are ones, zeros and empty. So these all are the three functions which are used to create the numpy array. So basically from the tutorial first only, we are just seeing the ways that how can we create the numpy arrays. Okay, so this is the another three ways where we are going to create this numpy arrays using some functions that are ones, zeros and empty. So we will be discussing about all these three functions, and just let me tell you that by the names only they are recognized at what they will be. So just quickly let me give you an overview that the ones function is used to basically write store all the one number inside the array. Similar with zero, the zero is used to like store all the zeros in the array, and this empty like gives you the random numbers. Now quickly let me just show you that how do we make these things and how do we do. So for that, firstly what you need to do is that we need to import our numpy library, import numpy as np. Okay, now secondly what I need to do is that I always tell you that we use a help function, right? So for that I would be using help, and in bracket I would be writing, firstly we are going to see the zeros function. Okay, so I simply write help np dot zeros. Okay, now I would quickly run that and let's see that what does the zeros function do. So just let me go upside and just let me have a little bit zoom in. So I would be telling you about the syntax and the parameters about this zeros function, right? So here we are. So this is whole the syntax for writing the zeros function. So for that what we need do is that we simply the parameters which we can pass inside the zeros function is shape. Shape means like how many rows or how many columns you want. Okay, so this is basically the shape because we are going to make array. So our array contains like as I have already told that there are 1D, 2D arrays, right? So basically the shape refers to either the 1D arrays or 2D arrays. Okay, so this is the thing about the shape. Next, what is it? You can just give your data type. If you are not like entering any data type, any specific data type, so automatically you will be getting the in values in the float. Okay, so this is the thing, and here is the order, like order is C. Now we'll just go a little bit down and we'll see about this order C. Now just quickly let's see about the order C comma F optional default C, whether to store multidimensional data in row, and just let me row in major C style or column major Fortran style ordered memory. So basically these two are the default. Okay, so these two are the default orders C or F. So now the C means the C style or column major, and yeah, this is the like C is the row major, and F is the column major. So I hope you got the point, and even if you have not got, you can just read this one. Okay, so this is the thing about the order, and after that what is this? It simply returns a NG array. So this is the important thing other than what we need to look, and okay, done. Now quickly let me go to that, let me close it, and let's write some programs for that. Okay, let's write that how we are gonna initialize this zeros array, we are using the zero function. So just quickly I have done is that I have taken a variable that is a. Okay, now after using a, I'm simply write np dot zeros. Okay, and in brackets I'm gonna pass some like you can say shape which you were just discussing about, right? So I simply passed a is equal to np dot zeros, and in bracket I pass 6. So now what I will get, I will get 6. Okay, just quickly let me write print that, print and in bracket a, and now just let me run it, and what I would get is that I would get 6 zeros here. And just see, just have a look that all these are in float values. So what I told that the automatic data type, the default data type for the zeros function is float. So now if you want to convert it into int, so you need to just mention that. So just let me comment it out and just quickly let me write, let's say is equal to np dot zeros, and in brackets let's say I want to write 4, and I would just give a specific data type. Okay, so spelling data type, and let's say I would just give that integer. Okay, and after that I would just print this a, and now when I'm gonna run this I would be getting 4 zeros but in the integer format. So just see that. So this is how the zeros function work. Now other than that, we were having a shape. Now here we can just give 2D arrays also, like I was passing only a single like value here. Now I can just give row and columns also. So just quickly let's see for that. And for that, let's make a variable and write np dot zeros, and in brackets I would just simply pass tuple inside a tuple, okay? So it's np dot zeros, and in bracket I wrote this bracket. And now let me give some shape so that I have given two rows and three columns, okay? Now just quickly let me print this b, and now let's see that what is the output. So we would be getting a 2d array here, which would be consisting two rows and three columns. So I hope you got the point. Two rows and three columns. Okay. So this is the thing how we make a 2D array. Now just again let me comment this. Okay. So like again and again, why do I comment this? Because afterwards it would be very easy for me to give you all the code. Okay. So that is why I just do this all the things. Now just quickly let me tell you that how can we just here what I have done is that here I have just passed this tuple, right? Now I would just pass a list. Now here, let's say I again made a, and I would write np dot zeros, and now I would just be passing this shape inside my list. So I would be just, let's say I would be writing 2, 3 only, and I would be writing this print, and in bracket I would be passing a, okay? Now just when I will run this, I will simply get the same output which I was getting, that is 000. So now here I got this list also. So this is the thing, like you can just pass tuple inside a tuple, or you can even pass a list, that's totally fine. So this was all about the zeros function, which we have seen that I will discuss with you. Now, just leaving the zeros function, let's quickly move towards the ones function. Now ones function is just similar as zeros. So quickly let me write help, and I will write help dot ones, help bracket np dot ones. Now I want to just see that what is there in this ones function, okay? What are the things that are there in this ones function? So for that, what I have done is that I simply write help, and now here I got the parameters that inside this also. The parameters are as same as zero. So basically I have shape, I have data type, and I have order. Order is also same, that is C. And other than that, parameters are always same. And order is also same, that is C and F, just that is optional, and default is C, whether to store multi-dimensional array and all these things. So I have just discussed about that, and yeah, the output which you will be getting is an ND array, okay? Array of ones with given shape and data type, whatever the shape or data type we have given, we will be getting that same, okay? So now here it is written that data type is optional, okay? So this is the thing, and this is all about the ones function. Now let's have some try hands on about this. I am sorry about this function. Okay, this help function. Sorry, this ones function. I'm sorry. Just quickly let me comment it out, and here we are. Now what I would be doing is that I would just replacing the things. Okay, so I would be writing ones here, and in the brackets I would be simply passing. Let's say I would be passing 4, okay? And now when I'm going to run this, I would be getting the 4 ones in our 1D array. So see, and yeah, the default data type is also float for ones also, okay? So as I told, it is just similar to the zeros function. The only difference is that the zeros function gives us 0 and ones function gives us ones returned in the array, okay? So this is the only difference. Now quickly, let me just do some more operations on that, and just let's say a is equal to np dot ones, and here let's say I wanna pass any other what I would be doing is that I would be giving some shape, and that shape would be let's say 3, 4. So what I have done is there, I have just simply given the shape that 3, 4 is my shape, okay? Now I would be just passing a data type also here, and the spelling for why I am writing the wrong spellings, and okay, data type is equal to integer. Okay, so basically what's the thing? Okay, sorry, I'm sorry, we just can't write this data type inside the tuple, okay? So here, just let me quickly run this, and after that I will be showing you data types, okay? So this is about that three cross four, and so we have got 3 rows and 4 columns, okay? So this was about the giving rows and columns. Now just let me copy this. Okay, I'm sorry, just let me copy, and okay, just hold on for a second, and just let me comment this also. Okay, here now if I want to give some change some data type also, so what I will do, let's say I write 5, and now here I would just pass data type, okay? 3YPE and I will put equal to, and here let's say I would print integer. Okay, now when I'm going to run this, I would be not getting float values, I would be getting integer values. So this was about the ones function which I had just discussed about you. So here this was the thing how like we can print 1D arrays. This was about the 2D arrays, and this was about just changing a data type. So this was about the ones function which I was telling you. Now the last mention for today's video is about the empty function. Now quickly let me again write help, and in bracket I would be passing np dot empty. Okay, and now I would be running this, and let's see that what does this empty function helps us to do. And okay, just let me zoom in. Okay, so this one is the thing. Now just see that empty function is also having the same parameters, like the parameters inside empty function, which we can use the shape, data type and flow and order. Sorry, so basically here the data type is also the same, that is like default data type is float. Okay, now just see that what does this empty function return. So it returns a new array of given shape and type, and just where's the scroller, and okay, shape and type without initializing entries. So basically what it does is that it basically gives us the random values. Okay, right? So here what I have done is what it returns is the ND array only. Okay, so this is the same. Now just quickly let's go above and just let's close this help function. Okay, so I have just told you about the parameters, that what are the parameters that this empty function contains. Now you need to explore all the things on your own only. Okay, so this is the thing, and just let me copy the above one. Okay, this one, and let me paste that. Okay, so here I go. Now here what I would be just changing is that I would be writing a is equal to np dot empty, and let's say in bracket I passed 4. Okay, let's say in bracket I passed 4 and I simply print a. Now after running this, just see that what is the output I'm getting. Just see. So basically what is this, I just got some random values here, right? 1 2 3 4, I got 4 random values. So basically this is about the empty function, that it just creates any random array to us. Now let's say I want to change this, I just want a 2D array. Okay, so for just 2D array, what I will do is that I will just, in place of this ones, I will just pass just let me change this ones to empty first. Okay, empty, and inside this list, let's say I want to pass 2, 3. I want these values, and other than that I would the data type to be, okay, I have a data type to be my integer. Okay, so now when I am gonna run this, I would be getting 2, 3, like 2 rows and 3 columns array, that would be random, and the data type would be integer. So see, just in the random I just got 0, 0, 0. Now just let's again run that. See, now again I got some another array of like 2, 3, two rows and 3 columns. Now let's again once more run this. So see, now again I got 0, 0, 0. So this is the thing that you do when like you use this empty function. So it will basically give you some it just give you some random values. Okay, just some random values. So like 2-3 times I was getting 0, 0, 0. Now this I am getting some big values, negative, positive, and all that, like it comprises all of these things. So this was all about the ones, zero and empty functions. So these are the way how we use all these three functions for declaring and making our arrays, creating arrays using NumPy. So basically it is used whenever, like let's say you want a array that contains all zeros. So this is the thing. Now once is used whenever you want all the array numbers to be one, and other than that empty, just like it works whenever you want a random array. Okay, so this is the thing about all these things, and I hope I made all these things very clear to you. And okay, so this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and bye bye.